We need to make you an iron farm. What is up, guys? It is Farzy here, and today I'm gonna teach you how to make a farm that literally gets you infinite iron at an insanely fast rate. This farm truly is overpowered. Let's begin. All right, there are a ton of blocks you're gonna need. You're gonna need 6 villagers, 1 zombie, 64 blocks, 64 slabs, 6 beds, 2 trapdoors, 10 fences, 10 fence gates, 2 carpets, 1 cauldron, 2 water buckets, 1 name tag, and 6 villager workstations. If you're confused about the workstations, here are some examples. You can use a stone cutter, you can use a smithing table, cartography table, loom, composter, barrel, etc. Just get something with a UI and let's begin. Alright, first things first, take out your building blocks, and we are going to start building up into the sky. You want to go about 30 blocks in the sky, somewhere around 20 to 30, but make sure you're pretty high up there. When you think you're high enough, take out your cauldron, and put the cauldron right there in the middle. Then, on each side, you're going to go out 4 more blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, and on the other side, 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, pay close attention, this part might get confusing. So go to each one of these sides and bring it down 2 more. Then on that last block, go to each side by 1, then bring those 2 sides down by 1. So it's gonna look kinda like a Y. Do that on both sides. Once again, you come down 2 more, each out on each side, then down 1 more. Now take out your beds. You're going to place a bed on these 2 blocks here, then some on these 4 blocks right here, then put a block right here next to all the pillows. Now on the other side, do the exact same thing. Bed, 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 block near all the pillows. Now you can break your Y shape, but keep that 1 block next to the pillows. That is very important. Just to be clear, make sure you have 4 blocks off your middle pillar, then 1 block between all the pillows on the bed. Now, you're going to build out that 1 block near the pillows out 1 more. Above that second block, put down your workstation. I'm gonna do a composter, then you can break that block. Now, on that remaining block, put down a trap door, and against it, put down a bucket of water. So do that on both sides. Once again, you're going to bring it out 1 more, put down a workstation, put down a trap door, and then put down a bucket of water above the trap door. Now take out more workstations, and you're gonna put down 1 on each side of the water, on both sides. Now above that lower back composter, put down a building block, then a slab above that. Take out your slabs and your trap doors. You're going to go to this back block. On the top half, place down 1, 2, and 3 slabs. Break the back 2 and put a trap door on that slab facing towards the water, just like this. Have I lost you yet? Take a deep breath. The hard part's basically over. Let's keep going. Now take out your carpets, and you're gonna put a carpet on this slab touching the trap door on both sides. Now take out some torches. You don't have to do this, but if you don't put torches on your workstations, zombies might spawn up here. So I recommend, for your own peace of mind and sanity, put some torches on those 4 workstations. Now you can break this giant T shape. You can break these 4 blocks on both sides, and you can break the pillar going all the way down. Leave everything else up there. Take out your building blocks, go on top of the cauldron, and build up 3. 1, 2, 3. Now we're going to go out in each direction by 2. Make a cross. Once again, you're going out by 2 in each direction. You're gonna fill in your empty corners and make a 5x5 square. Now here's the last possible hard part, so pay close attention. You're gonna break the middle block and break the 2 blocks under it so you can see the cauldron. Now, pick 2 sides and you're going to put fences 1 off that side. So just put down a block and put some fences 1 off, 1 above your layer of blocks. Once again, that is gonna be on both sides. So go to the opposite side, do the same thing. Go 1 up, go 1 off, and put a row of fences just like that. Now on the other 2 sides, you're gonna do the same thing, but with fence gates, and you're gonna open them up. So put down a bunch of fence gates. It's probably easier if you do all the blocks here. and then just break them afterwards. But put these all down, then open them all up on both sides. Now, once you make sure this is correct, do what I said before. Put some torches down, because you don't want zombies spawning up here and messing up your farm, messing up your villagers. So just put some torches there, just for your own peace of mind. Okay, now you're gonna take out your villagers. If you're in survival, you can use a minecart, use an elevator, use a boat, use whatever. But you gotta transport them up into these pens. Three on each side. So get three into this water over here, then get three in the other water over there. I know it's annoying, but you have to do this. This is how the farm works. You need six villagers up here. Once you have three villagers in each pen, you're gonna get a zombie up here and you're going to move him into the cauldron. But you're going to see it's daytime. The zombie might die, so I'd recommend you do the zombie portion at night. So you'll see now it's nighttime. Now if I put him in here, he'll be okay. Now the goal is to push him into the cauldron. Now you're gonna see he's gonna fight a lot. You might have to hit him a few times, but you're gonna eventually get him in that hole. Okay, boom, I got him in. Now put a name tag on him so he won't despawn. And now you're gonna see golems are already spawning up here because his presence alerts the villagers to summon in golems. But you're gonna see the golems aren't going anywhere. They're just staying still. So here comes our next part. Take out your block and put it above the zombie's head so there's no more hole. That way he won't die from sunlight. Now take out your slab, put that right under the middle block. That's for mechanical reasons. And finally, put a water bucket right in the middle up here. That way the golems will get thrown off the side and you can see down they go. And that's it. The farm is done. Now the villagers will summon about a golem or two every 30 to 60 seconds. So it is very fast, very efficient. But now you're gonna want a way to kill the golems because they can collect down there, which is fine, but you gotta kill them yourself. So let's make an automatic killing chamber down here. Now there are tons of different kill chambers, but my favorite is the one I have right here in my own survival world, which is just a giant collection of water with lava in the middle. So basically, just make a giant rectangle, put water on each of the long ends, and have the water stop at a certain point. Put lava one block down, and you're gonna see when a golem falls down into that lava, his head's gonna get burned, but his body will fall down into these hoppers, which leads into a chest like this. Now that should be simple enough, but if you're lazy, you could just go kill him yourself, but that's gonna take a while. I think you're better off just making some sort of water lava kill chamber. And you can see it's only been about a minute and we already have, what is that, like 8 or 9 golems down here. If you do this farm the way I showed you, you're gonna get a ridiculous amount of iron. Alright guys, I hope you enjoy your new iron farm. I hope you get tons of iron and I hope you have a ton of fun. If you want to see more videos like this, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell. I'm not just saying that, please actually do it. But regardless, make sure to like, subscribe, do all the good stuff, and I'll talk to you guys next time. So until then, goodbye.